So, what is the role of devotion in spiritual path? Devotion involves a form, okay, to start with. And the person gets attracted with the form, maybe God or Guru, because of the higher qualities. Okay? And he aspires to have that qualities in his life. There's a desire, I will have that qualities. That's why that he gets attracted. So that attraction, the mind becomes constantly one-pointed. It gets focused on that form or that qualities of that form. And this focus on the form and qualities of the form, God or Guru, purifies the mind. Because otherwise mind is involved in so many things. So the higher qualities of God, higher qualities of Guru starts purifying the mind because there is a one-pointed focus. So the mind has become one-pointed and sharp. So then Upanishad tell that God or Guru is your inner self. So that one-pointed mind is directed to the inwards. If the mind is not one-pointed, it cannot go inwards. Mind is scattered. It cannot go inwards. Mind has to see something higher, important. Then only it can go inwards. Otherwise, it won't. So that higher quality of God or Guru is in you. Then that one-pointedness comes inside. And then Upanishad teach you, Nedidam Upasate. Not the one who see, when you see as God is real, the inner self is real. So then what will happen, once you realize the inner self, the conscious devotion starts. So this is called Parabhakti. So now you see that God, self in all. So first you start with Aparabhakti, self in one form. Then you see the self in yourself. And then you see the self in all. Seeing the self in all is called Parabhakti. Self in yourself is called Atmadhana. Self in a form is called Aparabhakti, lower level devotion. So this devotion is very important in a spiritual life.